this thing. Ladies and gentlemen, do you remember the last video that I made a few weeks ago, where I talked about how life likes to kick you when you're down? I had a lot of stuff going in my life that weren't all too great, and I thought, you know what? We can be sad, we can be upset, we can just let it destroy us, or we just get on with it and make the most of life. I did. And then this week rolled around. Well, I really didn't know what I was going to vlog this week, because, you know, I've just been a bit casual. It's been the lead up to Christmas. I've been a bit poorly, a bit snotty and everything like that. And Lydia,
I do not hear that.
I thought it was someone in the shower upstairs.
I was like, there is a really loud water sound.
So welcome to just another day in the life of Tom.
So, you know, I'm just gonna put on my Wellington boots, as you will hear it in the background, go into my garage, and oh boy, that's just so swell. Exactly what I was wanting to find this morning. Now, I have no idea how long this has been running for. It could have been a few seconds, it could have been minutes, it could have been hours. But I'm going to assume a pipe has frozen, burst, and is now pissing water everywhere. All right, do I have an emergency water stop tap down here? I think this is it. Is it lefty loosey, righty tighty? Righty tighty, like that. Righty tighty, righty tighty. Right, that is all the way right. Is it going to stop anytime soon? I don't know. I have no idea. I take that back. It has indeed slowed down and water has stopped pissing out of the ceiling. Like I said, I'm assuming a pipe has just frozen because it's so cold in the garage anyway. And we've got a pipe that runs along the top. Now, has this caused any more damage elsewhere? Being, has water gone along that trunking and down in towards the kitchen area? Has it come down this way and gone down there? I'm hoping not, and I'm hoping it's just pooled inside here. I also had to say, luckily, it may have got a bit under the garage door and not flooded like, you know, in the movies, because if it would have flooded in the movies, Lydia's pet school rabbit would be an aquatic animal, to say the least. So there's only one man for this job. And he's not messing around, he's straight up in the loft. Now, this is going to become a recurring thing, eh? Do not start giving me shit again about the state of my garage, all right? We're stocking up for Christmas with drinks and all that sort of stuff because, just saying, I might be throwing one hell of a party and you better be sure I'm going to vlog it.
But we're going to need to get the water back on to be able to have that party at New Year, so in can we pray?
I have been given the announcement to lefty loosey, righty tighty. I've been given the go-ahead to turn the tap back. Turn it off.
I can hear the water pouring out.
I've got a feeling he's found the leak.
What are you saying, Ken?
Oh, Ken's right in there.
Oh, is it just on the joint?
It's split that fitting.
Right.
Look, he's broke it.
Oh, damn.
It's broken enough.
That's just from frost?
Yes, it's been expanding and
broken. Wow.
Split it, look.
Yeah, let's have a look.
Split it.
Wow.
Split it clean enough.
I thought plastic was supposed to be better.
Well, it's gone down the seam, hasn't it? Obviously, when it's been made, so it's just popped it open like that.
You're incredible.
Oh. Door open. Let
me get what a guy.
Where are you going? Hey, do you not want your payment?
That won't even get in here.
What do you mean? Oh, come on, man. No, 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 take it. Take it, it's an exception of contract. Come on, just take the beer. Yeah, this is the deposit. This is to ensure you'll come back. Please, sir.
Just to let you know.
I'll give you Madre.
I'm going out at half past four.
Yes, all right, no worries. Thanks, mate. Look at that, yes. We got him, yay! He texted me like, I'm going out at half four, and I was like, yeah, all right. I was like, I'll just probably go a day without water. Not when Ken Cassell is your dad. Hey! You're in the smart car again, coming to rescue me. Last week it was Alice, this week it was me. Oh, he's just another cat. He's another level, isn't he? I love my dad. Oh, hey, aren't we glad we've got Ken?
Very.
I can't believe he's found the problem already. I don't know what I would do in life without my dad. Like, I'm not going to go deep because I've been a soppy Tom, but I legitimately cherish the moments I have in life with my dad. Even when he's helping me out with something like this, or I'm going traveling on a trip with him, or I just go around to his house and tell him to go fuck himself. I legitimately, I cherish the moments
Because he's incredible. He is incredible. So I secured the down payment for my dad to start the work, and then this is the final payment. Like, listen, money's good, but you know what's better? The gift that keeps on giving. It gives him an enjoyment at the end of the night. It gives him a hangover in the morning, which reminds him that I am his very, very annoying son. Tell me you've got the part. Come on. What? Good news, what? Oh, you see what's on the line now?
Well,
what?
What's on the line, Tom, is your wallet.
No! It's good payment, man. Peroni.
You can either have this one.
Oh, yeah.
Or
yep.
You can have the left hand, which isn't split.
As if you've got one.
But.
What's the cost?
That crate of beers on your shoulder.
Oh, take it. Wait, I felt like...
You just happen to have the right amount of money, you know? Yeah.
Hey, I always keep a crate of beer just in case I need you.
You haven't got a pair of them, have you?
I might do, actually. Coming! Oh, my God. So, where are you going at R4?
Anfield.
You going for a meal?
Yeah, going for a meal.
Mate... Me and my sister caused nothing but headaches to this man. Do you know what? I was just saying that I can't wrap my head around for the amount of water that was coming out. Mm-hmm. I just can't put my head around where it's actually gone.
Over there.
Yeah, we'll do. So it's double insulated is what you're saying, yeah. And it's still popped.
Yeah, it's got pipe lodging on it.
So we can confirm that it has been extremely cold in the UK.
Well, yeah.
This is also giving me flashbacks to when I was a kid and my dad would take me on his building jobs. My dad would do the job and I would just stand there like this. Have you installed it already? Dad, it's been 13 seconds. I'm very impressed. All right. Yeah, to be fair, this is very reminiscent of my childhood. Right, go and turn that tap again. Lefty loosey, righty tighty. Anything? There's no way you fixed it already. Is that it? Well, luckily, I paid the deposit and I gave you the money up front, so... What? How much? Wait, how much was the part?
50 quid.
50 quid?
You didn't have any left, it's
a bit. I need to go and speak to my accountant. What's that you're throwing at me? It's not throwing the Splat. That's what the rabbit would have looked like if we would have come back in and the whole thing would have flooded. Oh, it's too soon, man. I can't be dealing with, like, another pet being gone. Listen, just for the record, at Lydia's school, they got a pet rabbit for the school and it comes home and stays here at times, which is nice because he's very cute and he's called Aslan, aren't you? But he's a bit of a terrorist. Because if I can roll the clip of when something happened, you'll understand why. There's no way. If you turned it off at the wall... Is that turned off at the wall? Then put that down. He's literally bit it in half.
He's bit it in a few places.
Oh my God, I'm surprised you didn't open up the curtain. There was just a fried rabbit stuck up behind it.
Look.
Oh my God. Yeah, he just likes to cause chaos wherever he goes. It's kind of like a miniature version of me. Just walks around and fucks shit up. But yeah, you know my tripod? Look on the tip of my tripod there. That didn't sound right. Whoops. He nibbled all the plastic off that. He nibbled it all off there. And at the bottom of all the feet on these, he chewed it all off. So if one day you tune into a vlog and I say I'm having rabbit stew, you know why. Do you know how much of a good job you've done?
Good, eh?
I've got you a tip.
I'm on a bonus offer.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
What? So you've got...
Hey,
so
and in case anything like this ever happens to you again...
You
get insulated. Oh! Oh, I thought you were showing the merch.
SyndicateOriginal.com. Go buy it.
It's all coming out. It's
yeah. Notes. Is that going to be filled with water? Oh, nice. Hey.
Look at that.
Look at that.
That's a good
one. What a bonus.
That's a good one. Try me.
So, in case you have a leak, you can pick it up. You know what? All in all, you were probably here less... Less than 6 minutes. Amazing.
If you want an sheet to pull out, I'm going to put a little £5 note in the corner. And I'll probably just settle the bill.
Shut it, you. He's done it.
Right.
He's actually done it. Dad, thank you. I will not tell you to go fuck yourself.
Okay, I'll you. Yeah, I'll tell you.
Hey, because you helped unfuck myself.
Okay.
I appreciate you.
I'll put this away then.
Yeah, put it back. We're having a moment. I love you. And the superhero leaves the scene of the crime. One mission completed, another one to go. Not all superheroes wear capes.
But they do drive smart cars.
I am this minute and small in talent compared to my dad, who is unlimited scale of skill and talent. I am sorry you're left with me. It's very disappointing. I'm useless.
Oh, wait, no, there's no way this is happening.
Ladies and gentlemen, things might just be going from bad to so much more worse.
My gardener texted me and was like, Tom, there's some dripping coming off the house next door that I've never noticed before. You might have had a pipe burst there. I was like, I'll go check it out when I get home. Oh my God. This is not good. Oh, this is not good. The whole place is completely drenched. Oh my God. What the fuck has happened?
Wow. So, yeah. It looks like there has been a pipe burst at the house next door, and it is bad. The floor is absolutely sodden. Oh my God. What? What is going on? Oh my God. This is bad. This is so bad. Oh my God. Yep. Is this soaked? Yep, this is soaked. Water is coming through everywhere. Oh my God. What has happened? Holy shit. Look at the damage from this water. Oh, it's so wet through. Oh my gosh. Wow. Whoa. Water just poured out from that. I can't tell if it's the water. Is it coming from above? No, it's dry. Wait, it's coming out of the loft. Oh, dearie me. This is not good, guys. This is not good at all.
Oh, you know when something goes from bad to worse? Well, I need to try and find... Is this a light switch? Does this work? Oh, my God. In the garage, we've stored a load of stuff from my granddad's house in here to be safe. And it's pissed through the light socket onto all of it. And I'm pretty sure for me, I've got to climb over all this to get to the stop tap for the water, which I believe is over there at the back. This is really, really not good. Oh my days. Oh, look at the state of this. Oh, it's all getting piss wet through. God damn it. I don't even know where I've got to find this stop water tap, man. Can you stop pouring? Look at that. What's going on there? This feels like this is going to explode. I should probably turn that off. Oh my God, right. I can only assume that this is the mains coming into the house, so lefty loosey, righty tighty. I think, I'm hoping, I'm guessing. Flipping heck, man. If this was my house, living in it, and this happening, this would just be disaster, like, absolute disaster.
I honestly cannot believe that there's just water pouring out of every socket in the building. That is insane.
Flipping heck, man. Time to go and test the tap and see if the water's still pouring out or not.
Look how much water has poured down the walls. It's like a fountain. It's coming out of everything.
I think it's something that's gone in the loft and then just poured down throughout the entire house. Oh my God.
Wow, holy crap. I cannot believe how bad it is. It's just actively pouring through.
Well, that still seems to be running, unless it's just what's in the system and it's going to die off, which it looks like it is doing. Right. We've killed it.
This is not what I was expecting to be happening today. Not at all in the slightest. Keep all those open. Empty them out.
Hey.
I've got to share this with you. This has just blown my mind.
It's got all the water's come down behind the wallpaper to the point that it's just... You've got to be kidding me, man. You've got to be kidding me. Oh my, what is going on?
24 hours later.
All right, so it is now the next day after we saw the house in its pitch black state. And my mum's here. I always have a parent coming to save the day.
Wait, wait, before we go in. What? You know when I made a video the other day and I was like, you know, sometimes life's a bit shit and getting you down and a lot going on. It's a good job I made that video first before this happened, wasn't it?
I couldn't be more true to the fact of when you think things are bad, it can get much worse.
So, what state is the house in? Is it... What? You took the carpets up?
I took the carpets up.
What? Oh my gosh. Hi, Twiggy. Oh my gosh, Mum, I didn't know you were going to do this. What the heck? Is this what you have to do after that? I thought you could put like a dehumidifier in it and drain it out.
No, she's just chucking out.
Well, the decorations have begun. Now, I'm going to say this right now. A lot of people might be jumping to a conclusion like, oh, Tom, you're going to knock down the house. Like, why are you bothered about it? Well, the thing is, I have mentioned this before as to why, you know, we don't want to just completely wreck this house is because if we start the work on the house next door, we were potentially maybe going to move into this for the time being whilst the work was being done on it. So the fact that this has happened... Oh, doggy. Has put one hell of a spanner in the works. Wow. Oh, wow. Have you seen the ceiling, Mum?
No, don't touch it. Just
like what? But there's a bubble of water in it.
Oh, Mum, it looks like a bomb's gone off on it. Oh, wait.
Yeah, I know people are going to be like, wait, what are you talking about, Tom? Like, this is all, you know, you can deal with this. Don't worry about it. This wasn't a problem whatsoever. We didn't care. Oh, at least this has still survived. We need to give this away to someone.
Oh, there's just drips coming out of that loft. I don't even know if I want to go up there because it's going to be so bad.
Right. Upstairs damage report. Wrecked. Water's come through all that ceiling. It's come through this ceiling. All the walls are soaked. It hasn't come through into here, which is very good.
So I was storing some, like, books of my granddad's in here, and luckily they're absolutely bone dry and not damaged.
Belver playing Fortune's Hand. Thank God we saved that.
The picture on the wall has got a little bit of a layer of moisture on it. Well, oh, oh, as does everything.
Oh, listen to the footsteps. It's bad. It came through all the light fixtures in here, came through that. There's this tank in here, which... This has got water around it, but I couldn't tell you whether or not this one's gone or not. Like, the floor's wet, but I think we're talking about there being another tank, because obviously there's water coming in from up there, so it has to have come from up, down.
It's all right. Let me go get a stepladder.
Oh, I didn't even check if it came through the ceiling in here. It looks like the floor's wet, but that might have just been from my mum walking back and forth. And, oh, the Wall of Legends! It survived!
I'm pretty sure I'm supposed to be adding like 20 more names to that. And I need some suggestions off you guys as to when we redo, when we build the new house, how are we actually going to incorporate it into it? Because I want to do it in like a really sick way. Nothing cheesy, you know, like nothing like a school where it is a name on a brick. Like I want it to be like a piece of art and you guys to be part of it. So shout out to the SOG rappers. Oh yeah.
But okay, off we pop. Thanks for your assistance, Twiggy. We've actually renamed the dog from Twiggy to Loggy because she's big.
No, she's gone to Branchy now.
Oh, she's lost a bit of weight. All right, Branchy.
One small step for man.
Hey, at least he's made the decorating job easier. Flipping heck, I nearly got off in one go.
Approaching the vessel hatch. Opening, lifting, entering.
Oh.
There's no way that's what's gone, has it?
Oh, yeah.
Look. Oh, that's 100% what's gone. No way. And it's just pissed straight down into here. Is this all wet? Oh, that's... it's a little bit dry, that. What on earth? Yeah, so it looks like...
Ah, sorry, yeah, they are right. They did say there'd be a tank in the loft.
That there is, I'm going to guess, a shut-off valve or something, and that there... is a tank, but I don't know if it's that tank that's burst or whether it's that fit in there that's gone, which I'm going to assume, looking at all the water on it, that's what's gone.
You know what? I've actually not been up here before. So it's kind of cool to explore it, you know, given the circumstances. Even when we bought it, I didn't come up here and have a look. Hey, there's a spare bulb in there. We like that. What else is back there? Doesn't really look like anything. But yeah, there's your tank. There is your tank. Oh, there we go. Bunch of ice in it. Oh, dear. Flippin' heck. Yeah, it could have burst at any different point here. I do still want to say it was that, but it could have been anything else, really. But, yep, that's the culprit. This area right here. covered in spider webs from going up there, but yeah, I'm going to say this right now, you know, famous last words, it could have been worse.
It's like I'm saying, the lounge, not completely ruined.
And two of the three bedrooms upstairs, you know, they're fine as well, so you know what? Yeah, it could have been worse.
And Mum's getting her... This is one of your things that you just enjoy the most, isn't it? Decorating. Peeling things off. This is...
Things to pieces and putting them back together.
Yeah, for sure. I reckon you could pull it off in like one...
You know, every cloud's silver lining. Maybe this is helping us. If we are going to be in here for like a couple of months, for decorating it.
Exactly.
So if we have to move from... the house next door to here, it might be a winner.
Do have to question what's going on in life.
Every problem that's happening in my life has something to do with water. Why?
Oh wow, the stamina I've cut through it like butter. Oh, gorgeous. Oh, there's so much water pooled under here.
Wow.
Wow.
Watch out, Tuggy. The fact that you moved all that rest of that in there by yourself.
Amazing, Mum. Well done.
Oh, nothing like a bit of a motherly son bonding experience, eh? I tell you something, I'll give it to Mum. She does love anything like DIY demolition. You like taking it apart, don't you? But not putting it back together.
I'm very good at putting things back together.
Yeah, I'm kind of the same though, not gonna lie.
Why is this an underground hatch? This is not to get under, is it? Oh, I found a basement.
Hey, we may have found some more treasure. Mum, I'm not kidding. There's something in it. But it's not. What is? I found something right cool. What's that? Senior Surface, the perfect cigarette of luxury.
Well, it's Senior Surface smoke, yeah?
Ha ha ha. Senior service ciggies under the floor. Oh wait, whoa. Sunday Mirror, September 1972. Whoa, look at that, the policeman with the dog. That's fucking sick. I literally said one of us is gonna fall in that hole and you just did. Oh my god, I totally thought you just smashed your leg open. Are you okay?
I thought my leg was...
Ah! Even Twiggy shut herself. Might be a dog poo around here somewhere, or a human poo.
That was just so ridiculous. That was scary.
Oh,
I'm
going
to fall down this hole.
Hello. Hello, little help. Are you okay? Lydia's bringing us cups of tea. Tea solves everything.
It's a bit scary carrying all of this.
Careful. Come and have a look at the mess of the house next. You brought cookies! What a woman! So, what do you think of the new floor?
I sort of quite like it.
That's what I said.
Well done. What a mess.
Look at the front door.
Water mess.
She literally just fell down that hole.
In the carpet trunk, you just go around the other side. So I fell about the hole and fell step down it. I was so lucky that my leg.
Seriously,
I'm not joking.
Oh, I thought she broke a leg. Legit. Look at it. We've ripped. It's just bollocks. To be fair.
Oh. Nothing like a biscuit after a hard day's work.
Can I give credit where credit's due? Mum took all this carpet out herself. And pretty much all that. I just helped with the other stairs. She's mental. She mopped all this up. Mum.
Thanks.
I love you.
Oh yeah, you said cookies, didn't you?
Priorities.
Satisfying. Hey,
whilst we've got her here, Lyd, what do you think about moving in here whilst the house next door gets done?
Is it
going to
be dry?
No. No, I don't. Well, I can hear fresh water dripping in from somewhere. Where's that coming from? What?
The tap's still going there.
No, I can hear it here.
I've not
Tom.
What is going on? Yeah, I'm here panicking that there's still an extra leak and you guys are like, wow, satisfying. Can I show you something even more satisfying? Mum, let's go poke a hole in that thing up there. Come on. Red, come. You ready? What? There's no water in it. Oh, well, that's the most disappointing thing I've ever filmed in my life. What about this one? Damn it, that's the same. Wait, I reckon I could pull the ceiling off in one. What this?
I like the way the skin peels.
Not quite in one, but...
Hey!
Good effort.
This is the skin peel bit. Slimy.
No!
Let's just knock it down already!
It's horrible.
You're knocking it down, why are we even doing it?
That's what I said. At most, I was going to put a dehumidifier in it to just help with it.
The carpet's needed to come up, I meant the wallpaper. Oh. We've got to try and keep it dry for all the stuff that's been stored in here.
True.
And just like that, the stair treads are off. And just like magic, we're ripping upstairs out as well.
You won't believe me, but I did genuinely say, like, I was tempted to rip out the carpets because I didn't like them anyway. And if I do move into it, it's a task that I could do now rather than later. But my hand was forced.
Oh, well, this sure is one way to decorate after you set fireworks off in a room.
It's actually very convenient, to say the least, to be honest.
Look at the water damage where it's come down from there, but look in the corners over here, where it's obviously come down through that. Just soaked it wet through, but surprisingly, there's quite a lot of it that's dry.
The house next door. The house that is always providing content.
You know, all in a day's work, Mum. All in a day's work. Flipping heck, man. Oh, God's sake.
All right. All the carpets are out. We're going to have to do a tip run to get rid of it. But this is just simply another day in the life of Tom.
And yes, it would be so fitting for it to start raining at this moment in time. The theme of this vlog has been water, wet, water, water, wet, water, water. And apparently the theme continues. But ladies and gentlemen, we bought this house like nearly a year ago with the whole point of it creating content. I didn't know which way like that would actually form, whether it be having bonfires, making zip wires, you know, making secret passages, you know, or it being flooded and me filming it and all that sort of stuff. The plan of action is to still knock it down and build an incredible new house. It's just that the moment I said it and the moment I bought it, I was like, these things take time, and the fact that it's been over a year already is incredible, but we have not given up any hope whatsoever. In the new year, a lot is going to be changing with not only my house, but the house next door as well. And like a phoenix from the ashes, and the ashes of the rubble that is this house, when it either blows up, floods again, or just gets completely destroyed, it is going to be beautiful. But you know what is more beautiful? Your guys' faces. And I just have to, before I get soaked right now, just say thank you for an incredible year of me making content for your faces, whether it's been traveling with my dad, with my family, with whatever, at home, new life coming into the world, life going out of the world. It's been an amazing, just insane roller coaster. And like I've said time after time, it has made me realize how incredibly blessed I am to have you viewers in my life. So thanks for dealing with the randomness that is the life of Tom. Never did I think when I started YouTube all these years ago, this is the sort of shit that would be going down. But alas, it is. I share my ups, I share my downs. And yeah, like half my life is on the bloody internet and you guys have been following me along for it. So guys, I'm gonna have to wrap up this vlog now. If you do enjoy the videos, make sure you leave a like rating, click that subscribe button. I'm gonna tease you that there is going to be a New Year's Eve party vlog and it is gonna be epic. And there's some proper old school legendary guests coming to visit in the vlog. And I can't wait to share with you who that is. Leave some guesses down below. I'd like to see what you say. But guys, I'm gonna go. Hope you have an amazing holidays, a great Christmas, and I will see you guys in the flip side for one hell of a party that is gonna be going down in this house. So until then, much love to your faces, and adios.